Why are you looking at me like that?
Like what, Maggie?
The way you were looking at me just now before I caught your eye in the mirror inside of a whistle. I don't know how to describe it, but it froze my blood. I've caught you so often looking at me like that. What are you thinking of when you look at me like that?
I wasn't conscious of looking at you, Maggie.
Well, I was conscious of it. What were you thinking of?
I don't remember thinking of anything, Maggie.
Look, Britt. See how high my body stays on me? Nothing is falling on me. Not a fraction. You see, men still want me. My face looks strange sometimes, but I've kept my figure as well as you kept yours, and men admire that. I still turn heads on the street. Brick.
Did you say something?
I was gonna say something. Then I get lonely. If the one you love doesn't even love you.
Would you like to live alone, Maggie? Huh?
No. God. What were you thinking of when I caught you looking at me like that? Were you thinking of skipping? I've thought a whole lot about it, and now I know when I made my mistake. Yeah. I made my mistake when I told you about that thing with Skipper. Never should have confessed it. Fatal error. Telling you about that thing with Skipper. Oh, excuse me. Forgive me. But the laws of silence don't work. The laws of silence don't work.
Maggie, shut up about Skipper. I mean it, Maggie. You got to shut up about Skipper.
You ought to understand that Skipper and I...
You don't think I'm serious, Maggie? Huh? You're fooled by the fact that I'm saying this quiet. Look, Maggie. What you're doing is a dangerous thing to do. You're fooling with something that nobody ought to fool with.
This time I'm going to finish what I have to say to you. Skipper and I made love, if love you would call it, because it made us both feel a little bit closer to you. I shouldn't have told you.
Skipper that told me about it, not you, Maggie.
I told you.
One man has one great true thing in his life. One great true thing which is true. I had friendship with Skipper. You're naming it dirty.
I'm not naming it dirty.
Not love with you, but friendship with Skipper was that one great true thing. You're naming it dirty. I've dropped my crutch.
Lean on me.
No, I want my crutch.
Lean on my shoulder.
I don't want to lean on your shoulder. I want my crutch. Are you gonna give me my crutch? Or do I have to get down on my hands and knees on the floor?
Here, take it, take it.
Thanks.
We wasn't screaming at each other. The walls in this house have ears. That's the first time I've heard you raise your voice in a long time, Bray. Crack in the wall. The sound of composure. I think that's a good sound. Sign of nerves in the player on the defensive.
Will you do me a favor?
Maybe I will. What favor?
Just keep your voice down.
Oh, I'll do you that favor. I'll speak in a whisper. You know that it's Big Daddy's birthday?
No. I forgot it.
Well, I remembered it for you. Just scribble a few lines in that card.
You scribble something, Maggie.
Just write Love Brick, for God's sake!
No!
You've got to!
I don't have to do anything I don't want to. You keep forgetting the condition I agreed to stay on living with you.
I'm not living with you.
You need to remember.
We occupy the same cage.
You need to remember the conditions I agreed on.
They're impossible conditions.
You could leave me, Maggie.
Don't want to or will not.
You don't have to take care of me.
Yes, I do. Two people in the same boat have to take care of each other. Well, I'm dressed. All dressed. Nothing else for me to do.
Maggie?
Mm-hmm.
Would you like me to hit you with this crutch? Don't you know I could kill you with this crutch?
Get dressed, babe.
I went to the zoo to find out more about how people exist with animals and about how animals exist with each other and with people too. It was probably an unfair experiment, what with everybody separated by bars. And the animals, for the most part, from each other, and always from the humans. But it's a zoo, and that's the way it is. So, hold over.
Sorry, don't you have enough room?
And all the people are there. And all the animals are there. And it's Sunday. And all the children are there. And,
move over. All right.
And it's a hot day,
so the stench is there too.
And all the balloon sellers, and all the ice cream sellers, and all the seals are barking, and all the birds are screaming, and move over.
Look, you have more than enough room.
And it's feeding time at the lion's house. The lion keeper comes into the lion's house, or one of the lion's houses, and says, "Move over!
I can't move over anymore!
Stop hitting me, what's the matter with you? Do you want to hear the rest of the story?"
"I'm not sure. I certainly don't want to be punched in my arm, like that."
"Stop that, what's the matter with you?"
"I'm crazy, you bastard." "That's not funny."
"Listen to me, Peter. I want this bench, and I want it now. You go and sit over there, and if you're good, I'll tell you the rest of the story."
"What is the matter with you? Besides, I see no reason why I should not sit on this bench. I sit here every Sunday afternoon. It's secluded, no one ever sits here, so I get the bench to myself."
"Get off this bench, Peter, I want it." "No, I said I want this bench, and I'm gonna have it. Now get off of here and go and sit over there."
"People can't have everything they want. You should know that. That's people can have some things that they want, but they can't have everything."
Imbecile, you are slow-witted.
"Stop that.
You're a vegetable. Go and lie down on the ground.
You listen to me. I put up with you all afternoon."
"Not really."
"Long enough. I put up with you long enough. See, I started listening to you because I thought you needed someone to listen to."
"Oh. You put things so economically and, oh, what is the word? I want to put justice to your, oh, Jesus, you make me sick. Get off of this bench and go and sit over there."
"It's my bench."
"Get out of here!"
"God damn, I've had enough of this. I've had enough of you. This is my bench. You can't have it, and that's that. Now go away." "I said go away." "Get away from me. If you don't move on..."
"You're a bum."
"Oh,
that's what you are. You're a bum. If you don't move on, I'm gonna call a policeman and get you arrested.
I warn you, I'll call a policeman."
"Oh. You won't find any police around here. They're all on the west side of the park chasing fairies down from trees and out of bushes. That's what they do. That's their function.
So?
You can go about screaming your head off and it won't do you any good. Police!
I warn you, I'll get you arrested.
Police!
I like the police!
I really
a fully grown man calling for the policeman on a bright Sunday afternoon in the park
when nobody's even arming you.
And if a policeman did fill his quota and come sludging over there, he would probably take you in as a nut.
God, I came here to read, and you're telling me to get off my bench? You're mad.
Hey, Peter, I got news for you, as they say. I'm on your goddamn bench, and you're never gonna have it to yourself ever again!
Look here. This is my bench, and I want you up!
Ooh, look who's mad.
Get out!
No.
I warn you! Do you know who looks ridiculous?
No. It doesn't matter. Get off my bench!
Why? You have everything you could possibly want. You told me about your home, and about your family, about your perfect little zoo. You have everything, and now you want this bench? Are these the things men fight for? Tell me, Peter. Is this bench, this iron, this wood, is this your honor? Huh? Is this the thing in the whole world that you want to fight for? Could you think of anything more ridiculous?
Your indifference. What is some kind of Chinese philosophy? something. I gotta do something. Money! Money! That's the way to get out of it.
Well, I guess money's always good to get hold of.
Let me think. Oh, I've got some kind of an idea. You remember Shep Huntley? Oh, of course you remember Shep Huntley. I went to college with him at Boris Penn for a while. Well, I bumped into him last winter. You know I went to Miami over the Christmas holidays.
No.
Well, I did. I figured it would be some kind of investment, thinking I'd meet a man with $1 million.
Did ya?
Yes, I bumped into Shep Huntley. I bumped into him in Biscayne Boulevard, getting into his car. Cadillac convertible. Well, it must have been about a block long.
But that was terribly inconvenient in the traffic.
You've heard of Orwell's? Well, he has them all over Texas. Texas is literally spouting gold into his pockets. Oh, you know how indifferent I am to money. I think of it as what it can do for you, but he could definitely do it. He could definitely do it.
Do what?
Why? He could set us up in a shop.
What kind of shop?
A shop of some kind. Why? He could do it with half the money his wife throws away at the races.
Well, he's married?
Oh, honey, do you think I'd be here if you weren't married?
You know, I have had an idea. I've seen you before. And I had that idea as soon as you opened the door. It was almost as if I was about to remember your name. But the name I started to call you wasn't a name, and so I stopped myself before I said it.
Wasn't it Blue Roses?
Blue Roses! Oh my gosh, yes! Blue Roses! That's what I had in my tongue as soon as you opened the door. Isn't it funny what tricks your memory plays? I didn't connect with you in high school, but that's where it was. It was in high school. I didn't even know Shakespeare had a sister. Gosh, I am sorry.
I didn't expect you to. You barely knew me.
Now, we did have a speaking acquaintance, though, huh?
Yes, we spoke to each other.
So when did you recognize me?
Oh, right away.
As soon as I come in the door?
When I first heard your name, I thought it was probably you. I knew Tom used to know you a little in high school, so when you came in the door, well, then I was sure.
And why didn't you say something?
I didn't know what to say. I was too surprised.
For goodness sakes, this sure is funny.
Yes, yes, isn't it, though?
Didn't we have a class in something together?
Yes, we did.
And what class was that?
It was singing. Chorus. Huh. I sat across the aisle from you in the odd. Huh. Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays.
Now I remember. You always came in late.
Yes. It was so hard for me getting up the stairs. I had that brace on my leg. It clumped so loud.
I never heard any clumping.
To me, it sounded like thunder.
Well, 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 I never even noticed.
And everybody was seated before I came in. My seat was in the back row. I had to go clumping all the way up the aisle with everyone watching.
You shouldn't have been so self-conscious.
I know, but I was. It was always such a relief when the singing started.
Now, I've placed you now. I used to call you Blue Roses. How was it that I started calling you that?
I was out of school a little while with chlorosis. When I came back, you asked me what was the matter. I said I had chlorosis, but you thought I said Blue Roses.
Well, I hope you didn't mind.
Oh no, I liked it. You see, I wasn't acquainted with many people.
As I remember, you sort of stuck by yourself.
Well, I never had much luck at making friends.
I don't see why you wouldn't.
Well, I started out badly.
You mean being?
Yes, it sort of stood between me.
Oh, you should have let it.
I know, but I never could.
Overcome it?
No, I never could.
I guess.